I gathered you here today to ask you about what's your favorite audio plugin?
Howdy there, folks. Skylar Crank here. And today is not your typical episode of Dirty Jobs. In fact, this isn't even an episode of Dirty Jobs at all. Today we are on this beautiful goat farm
to settle the age-old debate of what sounds better, analog warmth or digital accuracy, with a modern twist, of course, of AI madness. I chose the fuzz effect for testing and was surprised on how good the AI turned out. So here's the plan. First, we'll build an analog circuit, then we will write an algorithm to match it. Then, we'll digitally emulate the circuit and finally train an AI on that same circuit. After that is finished, we will once for all see who is the GOAT of audio. First up, the classic analog sound. Many argue that the warmth and authenticity of analog systems bring a unique charm to music. From vinyl records to analog synthesizers, there's a nostalgic quality that resonates with audiophiles. But is it really a better choice in the digital age? Here's what you'll need to make this fuzz circuit. I have links in the description and crudely made a circuit diagram that anyone can follow. This is the circuit we are going to emulate and train an AI on. Here's what it sounds like.
My, it's a tightly contested race today, folks. We got Dark Horse in the lead, but Seabiscuit is coming up. Seabiscuit's taking the lead. Seabiscuit is gonna win it all.
Gotta watch the pack. They already chewed through one microphone. How's it going? I will pet all of you individually, one at a time. Digital audio has become the standard for modern music production. Crystal clear clarity, precise reproduction, and the convenience of digital formats has transformed the industry. Does the perfection of digital trump the character of analog, or is there more to the story? To find out, I wrote a purely digital distortion using the sigmoid function and another algorithm that matches the frequency response of the circuit before reshaping the wave. For our purposes, we will call these two settings digital and emulator. And here's what they sound like.
And the goats, what's up, goats? How you guys doing today? Let's get this party started. You want to eat some grass?
Now that Seabiscuit is some horse, ladies and gentlemen. Seabiscuit's leaving the arena, and he appears to be going to a convertible. And now, Seabiscuit's hotwiring the convertible! Now he's driving off! He's driving off and nobody's gonna catch Seabiscuit! Seabiscuit's getting out of there! Seabiscuit's gone!
I know what you're thinking right now. Those digital distortions didn't sound a whole lot like that analog circuit. When I started this project, I wanted to test a purely digital distortion, such as sending the audio through a sigmoid transfer function.
However, I didn't know at the time that the convolution would not replicate the distortions of the circuit, but only the frequency response of a distortion at a specific time in the circuit. To get a more accurate, traditional recreation of the circuit would be to program the circuit piece by piece.
Goats, what's your favorite color? Really? Which movie created in the last 10 years would you recommend, Mushu? Cruella. Do you have any relation to Dalmatians? What time would you say that you guys wake up and go to bed? Deanna, what's your favorite cuss word? Oh, jeez.
Now let's throw artificial intelligence into the mix. With advancements in machine learning and neural networks, AI is making waves in audio processing. Can a neural net truly enhance our listening experience? Or does it risk losing the soulful touch that analog enthusiasts cherish? Well, there's only one way to find out.
What is this, ladies and gentlemen? It appears that Seabiscuit has driven to the Grand Canyon and he's going to be making a death-defying leap. And he's off! Is he gonna make it? He's through the air! Odds don't look good, but he makes it! Seabiscuit! Seabiscuit makes it! Seabiscuit made it!
I was surprised how accurate the AI sounded, and the AI even sounded better sometimes than the original circuit. So who is the GOAT? I'll let you decide. For those of you who don't know, I'm passionate about audio and making audio plugins. I put all the algorithms you heard into a multi-threaded audio plugin so the AI can work on everyone's machine and you can sprinkle goat fuzz onto your next song. I would love to hear it. I also hope you like the animated goat, courtesy of my friend Scott. The plugin's for sale right now on my website, and this is my first neural net and multi-threaded plugin, so let me know if there's any problems. I'll do my best to fix it. So be sure to like and subscribe and get creative tools for your creative ventures. Thanks again, everybody. Hope to see you next time.
My, it's a tightly contested race today, folks. We got Dark Horse in the lead, but Seabiscuit is coming up. Seabiscuit!